It's Monday today, the 2nd of May 2016. Just bringing up to date with where we're heading to at this stage of the court hearing between me and Detective Natalie Flowerdew-Brown from the Auckland Central Police Station. She's in Solomon Islands at the moment. The judge there, I think it's Collins, R. Collins. He'll be extraditing or bring her back to Auckland. That's the latest I've got from my barrister, Shannon Withers. He's doing a great job so far. He's listening to me and what I say, and fitting into the corporate system of judges and courts. I have our own native King William IV, King's Bench Court, operating out of Waitangi Marae right now, online, in conjunction with the High Court of Admiralty in London. They're online as well. You can do court cases yourself, if you're proficient enough, as what I'm doing, to know you get it right the first time. They'll take your court cases direct from any country straight into the High Court there on Fetter Lane in the Rolls Building. I have the judge there with our court case on 66 Cook Street, that Ford case, that I'm going to solve as soon as I can, get it over and done with. So far, the police have interfered, tampered with my information. That's my problem I'm having with the fraud inside the police force itself. I'm not frightened to say that, and to name anyone who's creating fraud or administering fraud business inside the corporate crown system, you'll be found out and put in front of the judge, like how we're doing now. And to you, Natalie Flowerdew-Brown, you did wrong coming into my house here. I'll keep saying that and taking my shirt off my back and confiscating that. You confiscated the King of England, the King of Britain, UK, and the King of the Pacific Islands, and the Commonwealth for that matter. The shirt, that is, of King William, his photo, sitting on it with his seals. Now, as far as courts are concerned, I just have a message for the judge and the police and Parliament here in New Zealand. You have no authority from a statement of confidence from the Queen of England and the monarchy there, the family monarchy, and Westminster Parliament. That happened. You can see online now. I've got it there. I'm going to put it in these documents I've got here of the police case against me. I'm going to reverse the whole lot and put it in this sort of form. This is a case disclosure. I'm going to disclose the whole lot to the world and to the High Court of Admiralty in London. Just what you did to me, I will do it in reverse. There's your seal there of the police. You see? You're going to have to tell me, the police, why you did that to me. In the position I am with the Waitangi Marae, I've always been on that Marae and talking all the law there of our lands, our native lands. There's no one checking you people operating businesses on our land. I'm there now as a native assessor for our hapu, not the iwi, the hapu. The iwi is there for the crown corporations, and they don't have any title of their own. They're borrowing it from the hapu and changing it all around. Well, I'm changing it back into the hapu title, straight with the King William flag here. Flag you see here flying and attacking me. On our documents. It's to seal the documents. And the seal of King William on his horse and his ship in the background of his admiralty, which is the mortgage inside this flag. This is the bank that I'm putting together with the pound note that we have the rights to print and levy debtor against any of you who have committed crimes of church and state or in crown businesses operating as private businesses or personal businesses same time. So, first of all, I want to say this. I will be putting these documents together under the New Zealand Crimes Act 1961, acts of what acts did Natalie Flowerdew-Brown break the New Zealand law. Which act did she break, and which act did she have authority to, or no authority to arrest me with no warrant? This is what I'm taking from my barrister, who has they have a problem with what I'm doing, because I'm following the law too of New Zealand. I'm following their law and expressing our law of King William IV, Westminster, 1830 to 1837. I can use any of those acts in that law because we haven't changed it. I'm going there to alter things and to bring us a new partner, give us a new partner in business to take the Queen's place. The Queen, as you notice, she's jumped ship now. She wants to get out of EU Parliament and go back to Westminster, where she abandoned ship. She jumped overboard, as far as this flag is concerned, the Admiralty flag. She's jumped off King William's ship and gone into the EU with the money that's gone missing. I'm going to track the money with the tax Panama scam that's going on, the havens, tax havens, Panama papers. I'm going to follow that up later on, as soon as we get organised. Once I'm on Cook Street, I'll be going in that office and it'll be sweeping from there. And I'm hoping, this is a message to you, the Judge Collins, in the Auckland District Court, that you will take into account my case is unique in a sense that it's coming from the Navy itself on the treaty grounds that Marae, the Waitangi Marae, is now King's Bench Court. All Marae's are courts in their own as native court. There's a native court with the ship beside it in the paddock. That's the Admiralty flag that's flying. This one, flying on the rung on the opposite the British flag, is partners to us. That's our contract. That's our contract fixed right there in front of the whole world watching me make these videos. And I want to spread out in these documents for my court hearing to give to the barrister to express under my instructions what we intend to do. I intend to take Cook Street, 77 Cook Street property, this time with no police interference. I will get it myself with or without my barrister, Shannon Withers. Hopefully he's watching this video to know that that's what I want him to do, to get permission and a writ from the judge on my behalf to seize that property from those landowners and lock them up, because they have committed crimes with their lawyers, their conveyancing lawyers. There's some good lawyers and there's some bad lawyers. I know Shannon Withers has come from the United States and practicing federal law. He should know what I'm talking about when it comes to Admiralty law. That's my field of expertise on these native lands. If there's anything to know about native Hapu lands, that's me to put it right, put the records right in that Marae in Waitangi. As you see on other videos, that Marae is my Marae with my carvings inside it from my own Hapu at East Cape. UTUTAONGA and UEPOATU and UETAHA Chiefs. Right? So there you go. That puts that in perspective of who I am and who I was arrested with all these documents that Natalie Flowerdew-Brown put together. She put all this thick lot of paper together to arrest me, a surrogate King William IV, with all this authority and this flag that got her here on these lands in the first place. They are ignorant people. Tim Duthie, Detective Tim Duthie, and Aaron Pascoe those people in there think they own the place and make their law for themselves, you're going to find yourself right in front of the judge, and by default of criminal activity through the whole system fall over, and when the law sets on you yourselves committing crimes right in front of everybody. And you were ignorant to me and the others that got arrested at the same time. You didn't realise that I was following protocol on a marae in Waitangi. That's where I get my authority from. And I want to say this. I'm going to check each seal of the police, the parliament, and the courts to make sure the seal stacks up to this seal. The black seal strip around the red cross is the seal of the British military. And Kingi Taurua is military man. He's my chief in Waitangi. That's authenticating these documents. He signs these documents. As you can see, when I put them online, it's got his signature there. And Jamie Anna Marie Stewart Patrick. Patrick, the 8-point star, St. Patrick's Order of the New World Order, is our authority to take that position with the Pope of what he's got taken from our Irish countries in Ireland. That's me, the Cosgrove family, the lawyers. We'll be following that up later, not just now. We'll just deal with Cook Street is our next on the list to do of things. And I want to go through this online with you. You'll see me spread all these papers out online in a King's Bench Court opposite the Queen's Bench Court. The Queen's Bench Court is a debtor's court. It is dealing with debt and right up to its neck with debts. And this is a credit court that I'm dealing with. The King's Bench Court is a creditor. And any time you see a pound note flying around on Facebook, that's getting ready. It's been around for a little while now. Those notes are real. And take my word for it. It's all real as far as we're concerned. It's an old Confederation note from King Tawhiao, pound note, and King William's coins, gold coins. All of that is in there as debtor instruments against any criminal fraudster operating businesses on our land here. We still own these lands outright, allodial title, and you'll see that expressed in documents that I put online. Don't be fooled by what you see other than what we put as being true and my word against yours. That's how we operate this law, L-O-R-E, is my word against yours. If you can't have something better, then you lose. The law stands as what I put it there to be. Right? Whatever I write sticks in a court. If I say that to the judge, it's up to the judge in his court to accept or reject what I say. And when two laws clash, the Moai Tikanga Moai law clashes with parliamentary law and local district court law, and police law, the Tikanga Moai law prevails over these country, Aotea New Zealand. Alright, so that's just to let you know, I know what I'm doing when it comes to law. Okay, that runs in the blood in our family, and we've got a job to do, and I'm hoping that I can get this wrapped up with Cook Street in the next 2 weeks, this month at least in May. Tidy all that up. It's a big job to put all these in place and type it at the same time. I'm a one-finger man typist, and it comes out very slow. If you see any mistakes in my typing, forgive me. There's no auditing or editing of my typing. It goes straight out like that. So it's unique to me that any documents of our seals on it, no one should attempt to use our documents sealed. And anything, warning to you, that it can bounce up against you with a pound note. Just think the pound note is a levy instrument to bill you if you get mischief with our law. The other thing I wanted to say was, when you go to go, we got the court with the judge, his courthouse, and his seal of authority with the Queen above his head. The Queen is still there, and the coat of arms is still there. So he's got to be swearing his oath, and his jurisdiction comes from somewhere. It has to come from either the Queen or someone else or something else. I want to find that out too. I want to find out where he gets his jurisdiction. I get mine from King William IV and Moai statue that's standing in London and on East Island, and here in Auckland there's a Moai statue in the museum here, and in Dunedin, the museum there, the one in Dunedin's got a hat on his head, that's the crown. The hat is the crown, the basket of knowledge. So that's who I swear my oath of office to, apart from the Hapu Chiefs. I swear my oath to the Hapu Chiefs, elders, up at Waitangi. They give me the authority and I go back to them with the goods, right? I produce the goods and do all the work for them. And they don't know everything, so I have to tell them what's going on in this law, in this will, in the man's law, L-A-W, and the mischief that's in here, of even the priests themselves. So I want to check the seals. I want to check the seals of the government, parliament seal, to see where they get their authority from and their statement of confidence to operate their business. That's why they're running havoc in there. Anything goes as far as they're concerned. They're a ship without a sail. As far as I'm concerned with our flag here that I have flying at the back of me, this flag here is our seal for the military to come here now, because the Navy is the first mortgagee of the land up in Waitangi, and they pay the bills of the Marae. They, I believe, they've got $3 trillion from somewhere. I want to find that out. And I have someone up, someone's tracking that down, and I will find that out where they got the $3 trillion from to fund themselves and paying the Marae and the trustees up there. You see, it's a corporate crown business that's running up there in the trusts. The Waitangi National Trust have allowed me to go into the Marae, the Waitangi Marae, and do our thing, and we've quietly done our business in there, and we'll do it online from that Marae. We're using that Marae online as the pieces of wood in it belongs to my family at home, East Coast. And I say I have every right to stand in there in front of our ancestors and talk. And Kingi is inside that Marae to talk for the land that it's sitting on, his ahu whenua. So that's him and I, the authority, with his elders, the elders there from Apui, and Hoepa Ebiha there with Willy Pater, my close confidence in them, to gather together the other Kaumatua elders and to tell the message to them. If they are not watching the videos, then I appreciate them being there to learn what's going on inside that whare, the main one on the treaty grounds, and its ship in the paddock beside it. Why the ship with the sail there is sailing without any sails and only our flag on it, and what it means. It's a bank. It's a bank and it's a courthouse. That's what it is. It's a bank and a courthouse where the judge makes the money and spreads it all around amongst themselves, not us. So we're there to shift the captain sideways, whoever that is, and I'm going in there. I think that's Jerry Mateparae is the captain of that ship, and him being the president of that trust, I have only a pound note for him against his name and all of those involved scarfing the $3 trillion away, we will get that back into the hapu itself that that's supposed to be for. Anything of mortgagee is this flag. This is a mortgagee flag. They're not telling anyone anything. That's between the Navy, John Key, John Martin, the Chief of New Zealand Navy, Rear Admiral. You haven't answered me, and my three letters have failed to do that, failed to come to Te Tii Marae on the 4th of February, on Treaty of Waitangi Day, 4th, 5th and 6th. We had a TPPA meeting on the 3rd. I was standing there talking about this, and expressed to the hapu and the chiefs that I was going to confiscate the ship, and that's what's happened. We've confiscated it on its legal side, online, caught online. That's what we're doing with that marae. It's still there physically, but on the business side of things, we're opening the business up from that marae. It's running business now as a one of another corporate business under King William IV's flag authority seal, right? His seal, not a paddle. That's what you've got in the Navy. You've got a paddle. Paddle is not good enough beside King William on his horse and his ship of Admiralty on his badge with the 8-point star. That's what your police, Natalie Flowerdew-Brown, arrested my shirt and me and locked me up without the shirt and took the shirt into custody with King William on it. That's a shame. It's a shame that the people that got here on that ship of Admiralty and this flag have gone and stolen King William and put King William in the police cell in Auckland Central Police Station, CIB. I always had a bone to pick against you people in there. Why I videoed inside that establishment and kept all those videos are online for everybody to see what they did to me, the native of this land, and you people are ignorant of the fact that you're here only on occupation land title leases. We're going to terminate, we have terminated the leases. You can see the letter that I've got online, terminated your leases because you didn't turn up to talk to us about renewing them. That's you, Martin, John Martin. You didn't turn up to the chiefs who were waiting for you on the 4th of February 2016 and on again at the 15th of April 2016. We were waiting for you in the Waitangi Marae, the courthouse that now we use against you for not being there for us. You're there for John Key and his corporate Crown government and his false flag, football flag, firm. And that failed, and everything else failed after that, if you don't come and talk to us. So it's going to go through court now. I'm putting everything on the line, on the line. Everyone I name is going in there in front of the Judge Collins and Judge Fraser. Okay, so those two judges, Judge Fraser found me innocent. This is the irony of courts. When they see there's something not quite right, they're going to think twice about what I'm saying on this video in front of everybody, witnessing everything I do. I don't leave it hanging around here. I'll chuck it out online so everybody can see. They are my witnesses, and everybody knows before the judge gets to see. That's why I'm telling you, you'll get to see all this when I finish doing it in a King's Bench court style. Same paper, same words, different meanings, different seal. A higher authority seal of a king that got them here in the first place and allowed them to use our Admiralty law that John Key's using to make piracy work for them. It's a decoration of war flag for people who break the law. And in piracy, in Admiralty law, we're the only ones that can use the Admiralty law now, and no one else, now that the Pope has destroyed it from anyone using it in his around the world in the parliaments that they own. They can't use it anymore. They're going into the new world order. We're getting ready to go into the new world order with all the lot that I do. Everything I do online with the 8-point star is the new world order that Putin will go and destroy and leave us alone in the New World Order, back with its rightful owners, the Irish. That's me, the Irish, and Jamie, the Irish, and Scottish. Right, the Scottish land title creators of these land blocks, the Rogans, Irish, and my family, married my Wanoa family, and the Cosgrove, Irish, married my family as well. Rogan is Scottish, and Cosgrove is Irish in my family, and Jamie's family is Scottish Irish as well, the Patrick family and the Stuarts, right? Patrick Irish, English, and the 8-point star New World Order is what the Pope is running on, the Patrick's family, and the Stuarts, the Scotland Yard side of why she's like she is, investigating like how I am, working together for the common good of people and mankind throughout the world to save it from disaster of what Obama has done, wrecked the whole of America, and Hillary Clinton wrecked the whole of America, and trying to wreck the rest of the world with it, with their laws. So people, that's all I want to say for now, and I'll just get on with things and put this court case together. It'll take me 2 or 3 days, and then I'll put it online so that you can see the whole case out in the open, split right open, with me there as being victim and injured person. And the injurer is Natalie Flowerdew-Brown, detective, CIB, and Aaron Pascoe, CIB, detective, Auckland Central, and Tim Duffy, CIB, detective, Auckland Central Police Station. They are the three that gets the bill, £1 trillion on their heads. And for every day thereafter on Cook Street, the landowners, they've got a £1 trillion note on their head as well. Their queen and Rothschild and the Pope will pick up the balance of what's owing after they've been screwed over by the members who join us. And their sheriffs will be trading sheriffs up with real sheriffs from Britain. And the military will sort that out for us. They're our partners under this flag. They're obligated to pick up the tab and take the pound note that I write on it to them to do our business and kick it off and go and round up all these terrible people around the world like John Key, trying to steal everything off the man and the ordinary people. And I'm saying this not only for Maori here, but for everybody living here on the land. If you're good enough to come and join us in the Moai King William Party, then we shall make a new thing of the changes I'm going through at the moment to run ourselves for ourselves. Thank you very much. Today, John Wanoa, Auckland, New Zealand, Otahuhu, a nice place in this area of South Auckland.